Good evening. I'm Woolly Doug, and this is the Gameshark Week in Review. There are big waves being made in the video game world this week, and if these were actual, not metaphorical waves, they would tower over 80 feet high and wreak immeasurable havoc on our coastal cities. The wave maker, of course, is Sega, and their confirmation that they are stopping Dreamcast production. Come March 31st, there will be no more Dreamcast consoles made, and before that, Sega is lowering the price of the Dreamcast to $99.95. While poor people may think this is good news, it basically means that Sega is throwing in the towel and trying to unload their inventory. But still, poor people will now be able to play all the great Sega titles they've been missing out on, except for Samba de Amigo, because the Maraca controllers are expensive, and poor people are too poor to afford them. Sega also announced they are currently developing games for other systems, including Virtua Fighter 4 for the PS2. This electrified the gaming community until one by one gamers remembered that the Virtua Fighter series stinks. Space Channel 5 is also slated for release on the PS2, as well as Crazy Taxi and 18-Wheel Pro American Trucker. These three titles alone will add upwards to 20 minutes of gameplay to Sony's system. Here to comment on these big goings-on is everyone's favorite curmudgeon, Codeboy. So, Codeboy, you must be excited about all these big changes.
Yeah?
Did Sega's withdrawal from the console market dishearten you at all? And you must be upset that you won't be able to hack for the Dreamcast any longer.
If you say so.
Isn't there anything that upsets you about the death of the Dreamcast?
I like typing of the dead.
You heard it here first. Well, that's it for this week's GameShark Week in Review. Tune in next and every Friday for more news and comments. Thank you and good night.